दिस सोर्सेस ऑफ अवर हिस्ट्री, मीन्स फ्रॉम वेयर वी कैन गेट द नॉलेज ऑफ द कस्टम, ऑफ द ट्रेडिशन, ऑफ द रिलीजन, ऑफ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन प्रोसेस, ऑफ द पॉलिटिकल, वी कैन से पॉलिटिकल स्टेटस, राइट? फ्रॉम ऑल दिस सोर्सेस वी कम टू नो अबाउट ऑल दिस थिंग्स. नाउ फर्स्ट विल टॉक अबाउट ताड़पत्र एंड भोजपत्र. Now you might be thinking that what is Taadpatra and Bhojpatra? Students, these are known as manuscript. What? These are known as manuscript written on the palm leaves. Okay, written on the leaves of palm and birch of bark. Bark, birch. Okay, bark, tree's bark. We can say, right, on the tree. Okay, and that if that tree is having a smooth surface on that we can read, we can write on that, they used to write, that is on the birch of bark of the tree, right? So Taadpatra and Bhojpatra are in the form of palm leaves. Taadpatras are in the form of palm leaves and Bhojpatras are in the form of bark of the trees. Now both are known as manuscript. Okay, now in this, what they used to write? They used to write, the kings, the people used to write about the custom, about the tradition, about the lifestyle of the people living there, right? So they used to write that, and from that we come to know about the language, about the lifestyle of that people, and that can be in Sanskrit language, in Prakrit language and in Tamil language. Now students, Prakrit language is also a type of Sanskrit language only, right? So the from that we can learn about the language that they use, the customs, the traditions, the lifestyle, all things can be known with the help of this manuscript. And this Taadpatras and Bhojpatras are found in the, means in Himalayan region, more in Himalayan region, okay? And they used to write all these things, all the things, all the events, all the culture, all the poems, all the dramas, all the scripts in this, in Taadpatras and Bhojpatras. And that is why it is known as manuscripts. And whatever the we can say travelers or whatever the historians got the evidence of such Taadpatras and Bhojpatras, they have preserved it, and they have, we can see such Taadpatras and Bhojpatras in Montessoris, or you can see it in temple, or you can see in museum as well, right? So such Taadpatras and Bhojpatras are our history. From that we can know the culture of the people, of the lifestyle. Now we people, if we want to write something, if we want to note down something, where we used to note down, we take a diary or we take a book and we used to write there, right? But at that time such facility was not there, right? Even they were not knowing more languages, right? They used to know only Sanskrit language, Prakrit language and Tamil language, right? So because of that, right, we come to know about all these things because of Taadpatra and Bhojpatra, with the help of Taadpatra and Bhojpatra. And that is why it is very important to preserve it, so that our future generation come to know about the situation, about the things, right, that happened in our past, the things. Now right now you are easily writing in your notebook, but you don't know that how our ancient people were writing, where they were writing, in Taadpatras and Bhojpatras, that are preserved, still they are preserved. Many were destroyed, many Taadpatras, as it is very old, right? As this Taadpatras and Bhojpatras are old, right, very old. So it is destroyed by insect, but then also many are preserved in the temples, and many of them are preserved in museums, right? So it's look very beautiful to know the history, right? You will come to know about their writing style, about their language, about their lifestyle, about their culture. Yes, so this is about Taadpatra and Bhojpatra. Now we will talk about inscriptions. Now students, inscriptions were written on the metal or on the stones, right? Inscriptions are also the sources of history. From that we can come to know about the life of the people, right? Now here in inscription, normally the kings used to write the orders and commands that they have to give to other people, or other, if they want to give or pass on to other dynasties, right? So inscriptions are metal, means they are written on the metal or they are written on the stones, and these inscriptions are long lasting, right? You can preserve it for a long time. Of course, if you have written something on stone, it's very difficult to destroy it, right? So inscriptions are long lasting history source that we can preserve for a long time. And even inscriptions are seen in temples and in, we can say, museums. And even the many kings and queens, right, they have inscribed many information about the victories, about the lifestyle, about any orders or commands that are, that means from that we can come to know about the lifestyle of that people, right? So if the kings want to give the command and order, they used to write it on inscriptions, okay? And about, not only that, about victories, about religion, right? That also they used to mention. We have found number of poems, number of things from the history. Now from this inscription, one inscription is very famous, that is Ashoka inscription, right? So that is very famous in India. So from this we get the idea about what? About the life of people in our ancient time. So one source is Tarpatra and Bhojpatra, that is known as manuscript. One is inscription, that are metal and stones, right? That are, inscription means metal and stone is used to write, right? In the, for example, if they want to preserve it for a long time, of course they need something harder, right? So they have selected this, that is order and commands. Now we will learn about copper plates. Now students, copper plates, it means they are kind of copper sheet. They used to write things on the copper sheet so to preserve it for a long time, right? So on copper plates, what they used to mention, the kings used to mention about the administration and about the donations that they have done, right? About the administration work, about the donations. Of course, nowadays if we want to talk about our this economic condition, what we used to do, we used to write the profit and loss in our notebook and we used to calculate it, right? But at that time, they were not having anything to store. Not only we in notebook, we can store it in our laptop, in PC, in mobile as well. We have such facilities, but they were not having. So for making the administration work smooth, for smooth administration of the particular dynasty, what they used to do, they used to write the administration work, they used to write about the donations on the copper sheets, right? And not only this, even they used to write about poems, about the really, about the victories of king, about the lifestyle, about their religion, about the culture. Okay, so this is what copper plates. Now coins is the great source of history. From that also we can come to know about the life of people, the what kind of life of people they were living, what kind of coins they were using, right? Right now we have notes, right? 10 rupee note, whatever, 50 100 500, whatever. At that time they were, it was not there. Coins were there, right? So gold, silver, copper, such coins were there, and they used to use the melt the metal and they used to make a coin, and in that they used to inscribe their photos or inscribe their pictures, right? So even coins, from the coins we can come to know about the life of the people, about the political status, about the economic status also we can come to know, right? That if they have golden coins or more and more silver coins, it means we can assume that the economic condition of that particular dynasty was very good, right? So we can make the assumptions by these sources of history, and that is why these sources of histories are history that are very important, because we come to know about the lifestyle, about the economic condition, about the agriculture, about the we can say the work, about the poem, script, and many more things. Okay, so this is what the sources of history. Other than this, there are other sources as well. For example, toys, right? Ornaments, clothes, right? So from this also we can know the history. We can know that what kind of life the people were living, about the means from the excavation, right? Underground, from underground or with the help of excavation, right? Khudai, the people, we can come to know about what kind of life, what kind of food they were eating, right? In many dead bodies, right, we have found ornaments along with them. So this ornaments is also a history, that from that we come to know that what kind of ornaments they used to wear. As I told you, toys, from toys also we come to know that what kind of toys they used to play with, right? So this are. Now, how we can come to know about this history? We can come to know about the history with the help of them. That is archaeologists, historians, and travelers. Now, archaeologists are the person who know the history. Are the person who used to go to the ancient place and used to dig the house and used to know many things and used to get many things from that digging, from that excavation, we can say, right? So many remains are there. Means archaeologists get many remains from it, like remains of they can get the dead bodies, they can get the coins, they can get many sources from that, and that from that they can after that they used to do the research, and from that research they used to make up the history, and from that we can easily know about our past events. So that is the duty of archaeologists. Archaeologists used to know the history, and archaeologists used to do the research of different ancient place. Okay, now next is